This is again another success for our breeding of this Japanese koi, because we were able to successfully let this breeder of this Japanese koi hatch their eggs. Hi guys, it's a beautiful day once again, and welcome back to Dexter's World Channel. Today's video, allow me to give you two things. Number one is that we are going to make an update about our Japanese koi breeding here in the house. Many have asked me, Dexter, how could you breed this Japanese koi so easily? Well, it's easier said than done. Actually, I have gone through a lot of this process of breeding. I have experienced so many failures, and now I have honed my skills and were able to at least perfect the breeding of this Japanese koi. And I'm so glad that just yesterday we were able to successfully spawn this breeder koi of ours. And number two, we will go to the places of my friends. Actually, I have encouraged my friends who are also breeders of this ornamental fish for them to breed a lot, because I am going to buy all their produce. Because the problem is, if they will breed and there will be no buyers for the produce, that's gonna be a horrifying experience. That's why I assure them that if they can breed, I will surely buy all their produce. So guys, this is again another success for our breeding of this Japanese koi, because we were able to successfully let this breeder of this Japanese koi hatch their eggs. In hatching their eggs, we have to, of course, prepare the spawning tank. We normally use a concrete spawning tank, but I made an innovation about this. I made a wooden tank that is just being placed with a tarp, and then we put water and that's it. The next process will be the carrying of the eggs, because these eggs will be hatched in a matter of 3 to 4 days. But along the way, we have to be very careful, because these eggs might be rotten. That will lead to the failure of the breeding. So what we're gonna do now is to lift all these plants that we have prepared to the other tanks. And this is really very important and very essential, because if we will not do this, then chances are all these eggs will just become spoiled. So we have two options, whether to get all these plants and transfer this to another tank with clean water, of course, or we are going to reduce half of this water in order for us to preserve the eggs. Maybe you will ask, Dexter, is this really very important to reduce the water half? Yes, this is really very important, because if we'll just allow this water without replacing, you know, new water, the chances of hatchability is really very poor. So meaning that there is really a low rate in the hatchability. And one of you asked me, Dexter, I already followed your procedure, the tips that you were giving on YouTube. I already have made tank preparation. I already have put some laying materials or this nest that you've been talking about. And still, my koi did not lay eggs. Well, one tip that I am going to share with you is the presence of the moon. You look at the calendar, and if there is moon, not necessarily the full moon, even the first, second quarter will do. As long as there is moon, then that's the high possibility that the koi will really spawn their eggs. Just today, just last night, I checked if there is moon, and there is. So that is why I decided to put these breeders together in the spawning tank, because the possibility of spawning is really very high. So we are going to lift this plant now. This is hornwort, and very gently we will transfer this one. I believe that this plants now have so many eggs on it, and you can use any other material like the thread, or sometimes we will use the sack as replacement for this hornwort. So we will load this now here, and by the way, the water of this had been stuck for 3 days already, and also I put some salt. Yes, this is another tip that we can always safely mention to our viewers, that salt can also help the higher hatchability of the eggs. So this is it. We will put this one now, and a little later we will cover the half portion of the pond. And guys, maybe you will ask Dexter, this tank is open, will these eggs not be rotten by the heat of the sun? Yes, this is really very important factor to consider. If you are exposing your eggs outdoor, of course we have to cover, because the heat of the sun can also damage the fry of the fish, because this fry cannot survive in a very high temperature, and also spoil the eggs. Too much of high temperature will also spoil the eggs, that it will not hatch. So this is it. We are actually now preparing a cover, and we will only cover half of this, because we cannot also cover everything, because they also need this oxygen. So guys, we will now get the breeders out of the spawning tank, and we will return them to the common tank. This koi has still plenty of eggs. You have the option whether to hand strip or not, but my practice, I'm not anymore hand stripping, because I pity the breeder kois. We will just wait for another time where they will breed. So maybe you will ask again, how many weeks we gonna wait until they breed again? Well, if you are good in conditioning, you can breed the koi every 15 days or every 10 days, depending upon the water, depending upon the food that you are giving. The next question maybe you will ask is, Dexter, what will happen to the spawning tank? You lifted all the plants and transferred it to another container. So what will happen now to the spawning tank? Well, there are still plenty of eggs right here, because there are eggs that are scattered on the flooring of this spawning tank. So we will save them, but we will reduce half of the water, because this water had already been contaminated by the milt of this male koi that will spoil the condition of the water. Come on, guys, let's go to this community of breeder of this tropical fish.
Bago ka rin. Ima fried dito. Wala na? Malito, gagmay pa. Goldfish?
So we will go in and you will see that these people really are making income out of breeding this tropical fish. So guys, we're here at the house of Nelson, and it's been also breeding this tropical fish for quite some time already. You will see that they have here these boxes, and a little later Wilson will show us the breeders of his goldfish that we're gonna buy today. So Wilson will catch the fish. So come on. So this is a female Randa, and this is the mother of the fry that we gonna buy today. And yes, also other types of fish. We have pearl. We have.
Ito na pati si Mila, oh. Di may rancho. Di may nombre, si Wilson. Thank you, kay anda si Dexter Worth Akina Sambuot, kay saka din yung mga pry. Bueno gani ara, kay api kita man niya, anda ele na. Thank you, kayo.
So guys, this is my encouragement to the community. This is in a little way that I can help to this hobbyist of this tropical fish. They are expert breeders also, and you will see their facility, though it's very small, but they were able actually to produce some quality fish. And as what I always mention, you can breed a lot, and then I will surely buy all your produce. So we will now count how many he can sell to us today, just for today. And for the next week, we are also going to buy the other breeds of this pearl scale.
Boy, what are you doing?
Kung doon yan, this smog pan ba?
Sakalan itu.
Ya, bebé, peleo.
So guys, we are actually now beside in this fourth fish pond that we have constructed, and we are now about to release the baby fry of this goldfish. We have mix of pearl scale, calico, and oranda, and if this will actually become successful, then 3 or 4 months from now we're gonna be harvesting lots of goldfish and even this Japanese koi. And we are also set to improve those areas, and we will make another bigger and deeper mud pond for our tilapia and catfish and all other kinds of fish. So this is what I have told you, that we are going to make this as our demo farm, integrated farming, and I hope we will become successful. And I would like to ask you guys to please continue on watching our videos, and please subscribe if you are not yet subscribed. We are uploading videos every 5 days, and we are revealing our technologies, good and bad practices about this farming. And I hope that we will learn together. You can also help me by, you know, making some comments on the comment section below, and you will help me address all the problems that may we encounter along the process. So thank you for watching. Please subscribe if you are not yet subscribed, only here at Dexter's World.